Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. Brian here for another pickup video. I have a lot to show, so I'm not gonna go in great detail unless I wanna talk about the certain things. So just dive right on in. So the first thing I have here is from FYE.com. Another upgrade that I wanted to get out of the way, but this is the Hong Kong Blu-ray, but it is Region A, and that is The Bay. I love this movie. I have the DVD. I've had it for years. I figured I'd upgrade it now. It is in, what is this? I'm not sure if it's, this is its traditional Chinese, simplified Chinese, but I don't know if it's Cantonese or what's that other, the other form, Mandarin. So I'm not sure if it's China, either one of those, but if you are watching and you speak and read this type of Chinese, let me know. From Severin Films, I picked up two titles from their sale that they were having. Of course, they always give you a sticker. Sorry, they have packing peanuts in their boxes, which I understand people use them, but they are quite annoying. So I only picked up two titles, and they were both upgrades. So the first title we have here is a Fulci film, and that is Zombie 3. And then, of course, when you get Zombie 3, you have to get Zombie 4. So the only one I'm missing now is Zombie 5, Killing Birds, which I will pick up from Vinegar Syndrome eventually. So here's Zombie 4. This is a Claudio Fragasso film, also called After Death. And we also have the Inner Vision sticker, which I have quite a few Inner Vision titles from them as well. So that's those two. I went to Second and Charles yesterday after work. Didn't find a whole lot going on in there, but I ended up picking up a few titles. I'm just gonna pull them out randomly here. So first one is I have the Blu-ray double feature with this one and They. So I picked up the unrated version of Cursed. I've seen it. I enjoyed it for what it was. I found a Warner Archive release of an animated film from 1982, and that is The Flight of the Dragons. I found this DVD. I've seen this movie, but it's been probably since it came out in 2004, and that is Dead and Breakfast with this nice lenticular slipcover. This is put out by Anchor Bay. Glad to have that in the collection. Found another horror film from 2007 called Joshua with Sam Rockwell and Vera Farmiga. I can't ever say her last name. Farmiga. Never seen this one. Okay, I had to get this because I don't think I've ever seen this film, and I know it's getting a Blu-ray release with the other films in the series. This is a Carl Reiner film from 1977, and that is the George Burns movie Oh God, in this nice snapper case. You also get John Denver, Donald Pleasance, and Terry Garr in this film, so can't wait to check that out. That's it for the DVDs. I got three Blu-rays here. I picked up Cutthroat Island with Gina Davis and Matthew Modine. Also starring Frank, I can never say his last name either, Langella, the one that played Dracula. This is a Rennie Harlan film from 95. I did a little upgrading and I picked up the Blu-ray of Rubber. I love this movie, guys. Anything to do with a killer tire, it's got a mind of its own. Love it. And then one Criterion Blu-ray that I found. Paid a little bit for it, but I enjoy this movie quite a bit. This is, I forget what year this is from, 92. And that is the Guillermo del Toro film Cronos. This is his feature debut. Ron Perlman is in this film. I really enjoyed this movie overall. It was definitely different, but I enjoyed it quite a bit. So that is everything from Second and Charles. I have one pickup from Declutter that I was surprised to find at a decent price. Now, part of the slip box is coming apart, but that's not a big deal to me. And that is the Arrow video release of The Bird with the Crystal Plumage from Argento. See, it's coming up a little bit up there, but that's fine. This comes with the poster and the booklet and the two-disc movie. I think it's the Blu-ray DVD combo, so I'm glad to have that in the collection finally. I didn't have to pay the, it was actually less than what it was when it came out new, which is weird because I know this version's out of print and it goes for stupid money, so I'll take it. So I already have this movie, but this is the Canadian version with the, it's the Blu-ray CD DVD triple pack. And that is Psycho Goreman. I love this movie. It's one of the ones that came out recently that I can't get enough of. It's just so funny. So cheesy, so stupid, but I love it. I know some people didn't really care for it, but to each their own. But yeah, you get all three discs inside. So I think the guy that sold this to me, this is the reverse art. I think the original artwork is the same as it is when you guys see it in like Walmart and Best Buy or whatever, but glad to have that version in the collection. I went to Dollar Tree, I got a couple of things. One thing for my mom for her birthday coming up, and then I finally found Orko to add to my Masters of the Universe collection. I went to the Blue Ridge Hospice Thrift next to the Dollar Tree. I picked up a couple things. I found this Goosebumps Hall of Horrors book. I'm just going to resell it, and that is The Five Masks of Dr. Scream. A nice little embossed cover. No artwork inside, but still an interesting find. Found a book for my mom for her birthday as well. I found three DVDs and a Blu-ray. Blu-ray's for my brother. He wanted Independence Day, so I picked it up for him. I found a brand new factory sealed Criterion of Wild Strawberries by Ingmar Bergman. So I picked that up. This is a movie from 1957, black and white. It's in Swedish with English subtitles. So I've got that for $1. I found the unrated DVD, the case has seen better days, but it is Soul Plane. of Snoop Dogg, Method Man, Tom Arnold, and Kevin Hart. It's been probably since 2004 that I've seen this movie, but it's cheesy, stupid fun. And then this surprised me. So I used to watch this, my brother and I used to watch this show growing up as little kids. I think there is a full series release of this, but I'm not sure. But this is an Australian import, but this is a region-free DVD. That is The Adventures of Blinky Bill, Blinky Bill's Red Car. You get three episodes on here. If you guys remember Blinky Bill, please let me know. This is from 1993. They used to air this on, I forget what station it was. I think it was, I don't even remember the name of the radio, the station that it was on. I think it was UPN 20, I think. That was the local television station here. So, like I said, if you guys remember this show, let me know. So that is it for that. So today I did a little shopping, as you can see by all these bags next to me. So I'm gonna start probably going order with everything. So I went to the Walmart, and it was a town in Maryland. I don't go to very often. So I went to a Walmart. I know they had this title. My brother wanted it, so I picked it up for him. I already have it in my collection. That's Small Soldiers on Blu-ray. I got one shirt for myself, and I got a shirt for my mom too. I already gave that to her though. But I finally picked up a Cobra Kai shirt for myself. So I love the movies. I've never seen the TV series, but I like Karate Kid. Alright, I went to a Target. I didn't think I was going to leave with anything, but I decided to pick up two titles. So I picked up The Iron Giant in this weird slipcover. Simple slipcover, but I've seen it. I like this movie. I'm glad to have it in the collection. And then I had to pick up the steelbook of The Wolf of Wall Street with DiCaprio. It's a nice, simple steelbook. Alright, I'll save that. That's the bookstore. I'll save that for last. I went to one Goodwill and two Dollar Generals. So the Goodwill didn't have a whole lot going on in there. They had a lot of CDs, but when I looked them up, they were empty. Of course, people were stealing stuff. I don't know why people do that. Well, I know why they do it. I just don't, you know what I mean. So I found two Blu-ray combo packs in there. One's from Disney, one's from Warner Brothers. So I picked up the Lego Movie Special Edition. It has the Blu-ray, the special features Blu-ray, the DVD, and the digital code inside. So it was pretty cool. And then I picked up the Mulan and Mulan 2 two-pack with the two DVDs and the Blu-ray with both movies on one. Alright, so I went to two Dollar Generals. The first one, I didn't have a whole lot in there, but I picked up three titles. I picked up Manborg for $1. One-Eyed Girl for $1. And I found the Ocean's 8 Steelbook for $5. Never seen any of the Ocean movies. I know. I went to another Dollar General. I picked up four titles. My brother was looking for vinyl on DVD, so I found it for $1. And then I found three, they had a whole shipper full of Blu-rays in there. There's so many they had in there that I already owned, so I was kind of bummed. But I still left with three titles. I got the double feature of Two-Headed Shark Attack and Mega Shark versus Crocosaurus for $3. I found Fanboys for $3. And then I found, I don't think I actually have this movie. Feast for $3. So there's that. And then finally, I went to our local, not really local, but it's like maybe 35 minutes away, 40 minutes away. I went to this used bookstore called Wonder Book and Video. They have a crap ton of books, movies, music, vinyl. Collect some collectibles. They're starting to do that now as well. I found one CD that I was listening to on the way home. I've heard this album before. I never had it in my collection though. And that is Stunt Double Pilots number 4. Of course you have Sour Girl. Everyone knows that song. Down. Heaven and Hot Rods. Church on Tuesday. And then my personal favorite, No Way Out. Love that song. All right, so I found 4 Blu-rays and 3 DVDs. I gotta open these still to see if they're good or not, because they tape them shut. So I have 30 days to return them if they're scratched or whatever. So the first title I found was The Fourth Floor with Juliette Lewis and William Hurt, also starring Tobin Bell, Artie Lang, Shelley Duvall, and Austin Pendleton. I've never seen this film, but I've heard about it, and I figured with the cast like that, I'll check it out. This is from 1999. A double feature here put out by Camp Motion Pictures. A double feature of Book of Lore and Grave Mistakes. I've never seen either one of these, but I figured I'd pick it up to check them out. So Book of Lore is about this guy's girlfriend is murdered in the same manner as local unsolved crimes. So he and his friends band together to figure it out. Strange circumstances lead them to find a bizarre encyclopedia of local murders called the Book of Lore, and I guess the town's cursed with the horrific past. Grave Mistakes is about a grave robber trying to barter with an eccentric antiques dealer. The two trade stories rather than goods. Tales of zombies, vampires, and ghosts are told upstairs while an unspeakable horror waits in the basement. So looks like it's some sort of like mummy. Yeah, there's a mummy story in here. So it's like I got a weird mummy on the back. So that intrigued me. And then the last DVD here is a film by Stephen Hopkins, who directed Predator 2. And that is the 1988 film called Dangerous Game. Basically, this is about a computer whiz kid and his friends slip past a surveillance system and get trapped in a department store. They can't get out until the morning, but then one of them gets brutally murdered. They realize they're not alone. They're being tracked down by a maniac cop with a demented vendetta against one of the unsuspecting boys and a twisted lust for one of the terrified girls. So it seemed pretty interesting. I like the director. Not too familiar with any of the cast in here, but it looked interesting. I looked it up when I was in there, and it got mediocre reviews. I give it anywhere between a 5 out of 10, but I figured I'd pick it up. I like movies based in like trapped in like malls and department stores, especially during the 80s. So be pretty cool to see what's going on in there. All right, I got four Blu-rays here. Again, they're all, well, no, three of them are tape shot. One was actually in a security box. So let me see if the disc is good. Seems to be okay. I think I need to clean it though, but other than that, it's fine. So the one that was in the security case was Sputnik, put out by Scream Factory and IFC Midnight. I've heard good things about this movie, so I figured I'd pick it up. It's a Russian film, but I believe it's also dubbed in English, so I can watch it that way too. I found an Olive Films release here of a film from 1989 starring Val Kilmer, Joanne Whaley Kilmer, Michael Madsen, and Jonathan Grise, and that is a film called Kill Me Again. Never seen it, but it looked interesting to me. I'm not sure if Joanne Whaley Kilmer is married to Val Kilmer, at least was married to Val Kilmer, I'm not sure. But Val Kilmer plays a private investigator looking to score some cash in order to pay off his debt to a local loan shark. Joanne plays a femme fatale looking to disappear, having just made off with a suitcase full of money stolen from her psychotic boyfriend, played by Michael Madsen, following a robbery gone wrong. The two get together, and then I guess trouble ensues. This is from the director of The Last Seduction, John Dahl. So looked interesting to me. I found one Code Red movie in there for $5. I thought that was pretty cool. Never seen this one either. It is from 1989 and it is called Race for Glory, starring Alex MacArthur, Peter Berg, and Ray Wise. So this looked pretty interesting. This is about a member of an upcoming motorcycle racing team. Abandons his teammates to join a rival team. He ends up playing second fiddle to the champion of the new team. Not satisfied and against the wishes of his new boss, he tries to beat the champion but fails. Leaves racing eventually to return and reunite with his old friends and attempt to win the Grand Prix. So, it might not be that great of a film, but I picked it up because of the cast, so. And then lastly, I found a horror pack film in there, limited. This is the horror, I guess this is the newer one that they're doing because it's number two, but I saw this in a video not too long ago. This is a signed, probably signed, it looks like it's signed. It's a film called Gut, directed by Elias. I don't know, it looked interesting to me, and it was relatively cheap, so I figured I'd pick that up. So that is everything I have for you guys today. I know, it's quite a lot of titles here. You know, I have no self-control when it comes to finding good stuff, so. Alright, well, I gotta do two stacks, because one stack is just way too big. So here's the first stack. These are all the DVDs I picked up. And then get the Blu-rays here. This one's a little heavier. Nice and wobbly. But it's wobbling. It's wobbling. Alright. Two hands. Okay guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. Please like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you guys later. Bye.